Als het intensief zou moeten, zou al die bomen weg moeten.
If this was intensively farmed, then all those trees would have to go. And it'd be a large field you could reasonably mow. Now you have to mow round it. You can't mow under it, because of the low branches. And actually, in terms of nature, it's just a beautiful view.
Kijk, dit is nou typisch Twickel.
This is typical Twickel. That low meadow with a clump of trees and wooded banks and cattle in the field. Those lower areas were always used as grasslands because that's where the water was. And then the transition here via the bank to the ash trees here, the high arable fields. There were always arable fields for beet, potatoes, so that was the arable area. A mixture of wet meadows and dry ash trees. This is an attractive working camp from the past. The camp is still here, and then this and the club. The commission found it attractive that some corn could be grown here. Then there's the ploughing. Freezing cold. Ploughing, and then immediately planting rye. I think we'll just have to work the ground once or twice in the upper layer with nice weather. Then it will dry nicely. And then below that, well, you can't do anything. Because it's all covered in weeds and rubbish on the surface. So they'll die.
Nou, ons waterschap heeft een bijdrage bij Boeren voor Natuur.
Our water board has contributed to Farmers for Nature because it's a very good concept. The farmers involve much more from his management skills. He has certain goals for this, and water fits very well into this scheme. So you've not only got your crops, but also water storage. On the one hand, you earn money from your crops, while on the other, you also get an income from your water storage activities. We're going to raise the level. We're going to increase the groundwater level. We're raising it so the water will not run away so quickly, and the water we will finally remove will meander much more. A more natural water flow. It's the intention to widen the stream in its entirety. Then it will regain its more natural shape, as it used to have in the past. Plant life has returned, despite the fact it hasn't been planted. There are small fish, and actually it's found its natural flow.
Ja, we zijn hier op een natte heide, zoals het heet.
This is the wet heathland, or heath as it's called, with here and there some fens and some peat areas. You have to manage a field like this, and in the future, the nature-focused farmer can do that and use these peat areas for composting. So then you have a functional management on the heath land, so to speak, and that fits in very well with such a closed business. And then when all the wild shoots have gone and we have a larger heath area, we have to maintain it, and then grass like this has to go. We're not going to pull it out ourselves, we've got sheep to do it. The sheep will graze here, so you get a really nice heath. That's Farmers for Nature at their best. So agriculture profits from nature, because we can let the grass be eaten by sheep, so nature can go its own way, the sheep are fed, and we can use turf sods for compost to fertilize our fields. This system with the old-fashioned stratiotes, with the old types of plants, it's not that you particularly want those types of plants, it's because of the system you use. What's difficult now is to get that system back into your present-day management activities. And every now and then I think to myself, if only I could have stood in front of the grave of a farmer from 200 years ago, and had a good discussion with him. How did that man do it in the past? How did the man create the circle? How did he keep his cows healthy? Those are the things I now have to develop myself. But I know that if I talk with a man like that for a day, then I'd learn more than a year at school.
Probeer hier de orde te handhaven.
Met kaasproeven?
Goed, zo veel groter. Dus je kan het niet als één man doen, want je ploft uit elkaar.
Wat wij met Biesland hebben is dat wij natuurlijk ook...
Here in Beastland, we're naturally also interested in what's around us, drawing up an inventory, partly with the Meadowbird Group, and with that data we can provide better information to the managers, so they can manage better. Because they don't know everything, you know. They still have to learn a lot. I've been counting birds here in this polder since the 1970s. Everyone's a volunteer, and those volunteers base their observation on sounds or sightings, but usually on sounds, judging which birds have which territory. It would seem that where the nature-minded farmers only use stall fertilizer and not artificial fertilizer or yeast anymore, the number of meadow birds has increased significantly. This data is also used by Altera to show what it means that nature-minded farmers can have a genuine effect.
Het was allemaal begonnen toen een vriendenclub uit Den Haag.
It all started when a group of friends from The Hague once wanted to do something here in these natural surroundings. We then met Jan Daundam, and he allowed us to cut back the trees around the farm and collect the wood and make a woven fence with it. And he also tells us the story of how he tried to work here as a farmer among all those advancing greenhouses and industrial estates next to the motorway. He tried to earn his living while he received regular offers for his ground. And he said, "The only way I can support myself here is to form a union with people from the city." But in fact, it's not just farmers for nature, but also farmers for people.
Elke boer, elke ondernemer moet keuzes maken.
Every farmer, every businessman has to take decisions. What are my production aims and what is my return? And if we look at the meadow here behind us, we see a monoculture of grass. The only thing that grows here is grass. That's the way it is here in the Netherlands. If you want to get a sufficient return from your ground, to show a return on investment, you have to grow grass and then produce it as much as possible. Because it's cheap in the Netherlands. Only it's at the expense of the landscape, at the expense of nature. The animals back in the fresh air where they belong, lambs as well. But the lambs have to learn it. It's great when you see that they don't dare to go outside, while very quickly they don't want to go back inside. And then you see the real animals, an animal that belongs outside, living in a herd. All they want is fresh grass, and to stay outside as long as possible. This is one of the best moments you can experience as a farmer. What is it we want? That in about 20 to 30 years we only have Italian ryegrass, no other plants? That we discover too late the landscape has disappeared? That we have no more diversity in flowers, in animals? So some species take over because they're natural enemies have no place to live?